莫因善小而不为，因为我们今天所做的只是冰山一角，而今天哪怕我们有一点点的力量，我真的希望今天接下来的拍卖会，我们大家每一个人尽一份绵力，因为我相信接下来的每一个款项，我们都会帮助到真正需要的人。
哪一位慈善家开一个奖来？拿到 Kenny 18万新币 ，Mr. David Yeo 20万新币，22万新币 ，Mr. Simon Wong 陈教，26万新币，陈文义先生 ，Mr. Victor Tan 26万 ，Miss Claudia Ong 32万，28万新币 ，Bai Fanli 26万新币，苏叶青，金英大哥38万新币，拿到 Kenny Wong 39万，陈。
48万，
48万新币，陈交，
50万，
50万 VCVC， 陈交，52万新币，我们的陈总。成交，
FND 72万，
成交，77万，邱彦豪，成交，
刘总。
周丽95万，成交。David Yeo 100万，108万 ，Mr. Jolly， 128万 ，Celeste， 138万，林金英大哥，158万 ，Maya， 160万 ，William Chuan。165万，33，180万 ，Andy Shaw，David Yeo 188万，200万 ，Lim Wen Hong， 250万 ，Mr. Lim Wen Hong， 成交。我很感恩，真的很感恩，也很感动，真的非常感动。一场这么短的时间里面，筹到的善额啊，800多万，这是从来我没有在一个任何一个地方、任何一个社团、任何一个企业，我能够看到的奇迹。这就是瑞威。
After I watch this video, my hair is stand. You know, when you have goosebumps, I cannot express what the atmosphere was at that point in time. This was a charity auction that happens almost every 2 years in Reway International. And this charity auction, that day when we were in Japan, Kyoto, the auction was held in a hotel itself. And in the hotel event hall, if you are sitting there, the chair, you will not sit on the whole chair. You will sit on half the chair only. Because the atmosphere is so intense. Very intense. And to raise the hand, you must be careful. Don't because your hand is itchy, you scratch and then your hand come up, they will ask how much you're going to give already. So must be careful inside the room. So whenever itchy, the hand cannot anyhow come up, you know. But what I'm amazed is just by having the courage to raise the hand and say one amount, this is the scary part. Because the amount is, just now if you see, They start from 10,000. The starting bid is 10,000. I was there. The first piece, immediately, the person shout 50,000, opening price. Not even 1 second, another person 80,000. And the first piece is a reway pin. The first piece went for 220,000. Not peso, Singapore dollars. And on that day, a total of 15 reway pin was being auctioned out. And the price of each pin, the minimum is the first piece, 220,000. And the pieces that were following went as high as 2.5 million just for one pin. So you can imagine the atmosphere inside the room, how scary it is. But the thing is, why are they doing this? It's for a Reway Foundation. And this Reway Foundation, it is to help people in need. Countries that maybe meet with a certain disaster, Reway want to help, they can help. You see, every company, they might have a foundation, but the purpose of this foundation and the direction of this foundation for each and every company is different. It depends on the leader of the company. What mindset does he have? Do you agree with me? Certain people, they will use the foundation for their own company, maybe for their own staff, for their own company's growth. But Reway Foundation, it is to help people that need it more. Just like there was an earthquake that happened in Indonesia. Philippines, not that serious yet. Indonesia one, very serious. Thousands of homes were destroyed. So Reway used the money in Reway Foundation before this charity auction to help. And Reway donated a total of 2 million Singapore dollars to help the people there who have lost their homes, rebuild their homes again. And that day at the charity auction, our Reway Foundation treasurer, Miss IVC, is also our senior director. She told us that the people who have probably gained from this donation have their house built up. On the house, outside, there is a Reway logo there. So these people are very thankful to Reway. And Reway is very willing to help. So this charity foundation itself, it is to help the people who are more in need. So let's give a round of applause to Reway Foundation. So, to want to help somebody or to want to contribute, it is not a very easy task, because a lot of people, or rather most people, including myself in the past, we only think about ourselves. Even my parents, sometimes I don't think about them last time. So to become a very selfless person is not easy. So there are a few industries that have many, many such people. One is a teacher. You know teacher? A teacher is such a respectable person in the society. A teacher is willing to teach, and whether this person become a millionaire or become a billionaire, this teacher's contribution might not be remembered. Am I right? But this teacher is willing to contribute and willing to teach and willing to give and let them benefit from the teaching, from school, from education. Teacher is one of them. One more, I will say industry, or rather a profession, I will feel that is very selfless, is a nurse. Being a nurse is very, for me, very tough. And I remember when I was younger, I also went to the hospital before. Not because I want to visit somebody, but because I was admitted into the hospital. And I was admitted into the hospital because I was a playful boy. There was a swing, quite high. So you look at me, I'm a very active person, very mischievous person. Instead of playing the swing like this, I play the swing like this. I climb all the way up to the top and sit on the top pole. I sit there, I feel so proud. Little did I know, the next moment I fell down. And when I fell down, my hand broke. It broke my hand. So at first I thought it was a cut, you know. I thought it was a cut. And then there were a few teachers there. Quickly took plaster, handy plus, and then stick on it to stop the bleeding. So after that, I went home and I didn't know that my hand was broken yet. So when I went home, I fainted. And when I woke up, my grandfather saw me. He said, "Hey, what happened to your hand?" "I don't know. I fell down. It kept bleeding." Then you know what my grandfather did? He take out the plaster and put another plaster there. And then after that, I fainted because I was losing too much blood. So they sent me to the hospital. And staying in the hospital was one of the most, I would say, enjoyable period. Because you don't need to do anything. You just lie down there and then there's people to come and help you, to shower for you, to change your clothes. I feel like, wow, I'm a king, you know. I feel like a king. And I remember there was this nurse in the hospital that will do anything to convince me to eat the rice or to eat the noodle, because we know hospital food is not nice, right? It's not very nice. But she will give me 101 reasons because I need this nutrition. Now, we look at the nurse. A nurse has to be selfless by nature. Not only are they selfless, they need to be very, very empathetic, is it? Empathic. Means they have to feel for you. They have to walk a mile in your shoes. They understand what you are going through. That is called being empathic. And this is a very, very important quality. And the next speaker I'm about to invite, his character is like this. He is very empathic, very kind, very caring, very loving. And when you look at his face, this person, whatever he say, you will also believe he is right. Because this person will not lie. A nurse won't lie to you, am I right? Right or not? So later when he say, we really must listen, you know, because I'm sure he's not lying to us. So let's put our hands together to welcome Tim Lee Pavo, King Bernard D.
How are you? Hello, hello. Okay. Are you full? Okay, that's good. Are you nervous? No, good for you. Okay. Have you ever wondered why it is so fulfilling to teach a child? Have you ever wondered what is the difference of a child from an adult? I know majority of us here are all adult, right? But I know why it's very fulfilling to teach a child. It's because the child can be compared to an empty cup. Have you seen an empty cup? If a cup is empty, is it ready to be filled with a lot of fluids? Yes, of course. And a child, a kid, is actually the age group where they are empty, where they are very much prepared to accept new learnings. This age group are very hungry. They're very hungry of anything. Anything that you will tell them, they will really do to master it. Am I right? I know all of us here are already, I know that all of us here are already, we already reached something in our life. Do we have doctors? Do we have nurses? Or maybe some of the people here are teachers? Some of the people here are engineer, lawyer, or maybe just a driver, or a driver, a housewife, or whatever vocation or profession that you chose, we already reached something in our life. Do you agree? But today, may I request all of you to please close your eyes for a second. Now, I would like to request all of you to forget whatever you reach in your life. It's either you're a doctor or whatever. Please forget that. And open your eyes, and now you think that you are a child. Did we do it?
Yes.
Okay. So, I am King Bernard D., 31 years old, a registered nurse. I am from San Fernando, La Union. And to our General Manager of Rayway Philippines, Mr. James Chong, to our Business Development Executives, to our Operations Staff Management, to our hardworking leaders, distributors, friends, and of course to my team, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am a nurse, but can I tour you back why I became a nurse? Do you want me to tour you back why I became a nurse?
Yes.
To tell you honestly, the coat, the shiny shoes that I'm wearing right now is actually my dream attire. This is actually my dream attire. Why? When I was young, I actually dreamt to be a lawyer. But why I became a nurse? It's because of poverty. It's because of poor social, poor financial family life. I actually came from a family that is considered to be outcasted in the family of my father's side. My surname is D. So if you know it's D, it's Chinese surname. Am I right? And a lot of our relatives are all rich. Majority of our relatives of our family are all rich. They have everything. But to tell you, me, my mom, my dad, and my brother, we have nothing. Way back 31 years ago, during the time that my mother and father eloped, we have nothing. I remember when I was a child, I actually envy my cousins. Why? They have everything. When they want to play Game Boy, they have Game Boy. When they want to eat bread, they can have different spreads at the same time. But for my family, if we have this spread, for example, mayonnaise, we have to finish it before my mother and father can buy another type of spread. That's the life that we had. About the story of egg, when I was small, we actually share 2 pieces of egg just to eat dinner. I know all of us here suffered from different trials in life. And the difficulty of life is actually depending on how you perceive it. Is it correct? Something that is difficult for me might be not difficult for you. My mother and my father, our family, we actually don't have permanent address when I was small. You know what? I studied in Chinese school in La Union. And every year that we go to school, we always introduce ourselves. What is your name and where do you live? Every year, my address is different. Every year, my address is different. And every month that my mother and father is paying the rent, I saw how they cry because they don't have money to pay the rent, the rental of the house. That's why, actually, we always change address. Until one day, because of the health condition of my mother, we were staying at the bodega. Do you know what is bodega? We stayed at the bodega of the house of my uncle in La Union. And I think that's the worst day I can consider that happened to us. We don't have room. The only thing that we had that time is a curtain, a rope with a curtain, and after that rope, you will see The dirty kitchen, everything is there. That's why in my young age, I actually told myself, I will never allow my family to experience that difficulty again once I grow up. So what did I do? I studied hard. I'm not an honor student. I'm just an average student. But I really did my best to graduate. But I would like to share something, because when they gave me this topic that I'm going to share to all of you today, I really reflected on things. What should I share that these people did not hear yet from me? I told to my last speech, in my sharing in the office or whatever event that we have, I hate direct selling. Do you remember that? I hate networking. I condemn networking. It's because I know that networking is scam. That's what I know about networking. But there's one thing that I would like to reveal to all of you. It's one summer when my mother and father went for vacation in Bulacan, they left me in La Union with 500 pesos. But I'm living with my grandparents. So my mother and father said, you use that 500 pesos to buy anything that you need during our absence, because they left for 5 days, if I remember it correctly. So I helped my grandfather, my grandmother in the store, because my grandparents are selling school supplies, wallets, anything. That's the business of my grandparents. Then one day, I saw the store next to us is opening a new shop. And it's written there, I will not mention the company, but it's a direct selling company of pillows. I was young that time. It's a direct selling company of pillows, and it's written there, membership is 499 pesos, and they'll be giving you two square pillows. And the first thing that I said, I called my mother and father, I told them, Mapa, I'll use that 500 to buy the pillow. And what did they told me? Wait for us, because during that time, during that 1990s, 500 is already a big amount of money, am I right? 500 is not a joke. But they said, wait for us to come back from vacation, and let's discuss whatever is that you're talking about. But you know what I did? After that call, I took the 500 pesos and signed up for membership. This is the thing that I would like to reveal to all of you. On that day, it's actually lunchtime. Lunchtime, I submitted that 500 pesos, and immediately they gave me the two Japanese pillows. And what did I do? In less than an hour, I was able to dispose the two pillows, which gave me 700 pesos in less than an hour. So during the vacation of my parents in the province, I actually started selling. I actually started doing direct selling. I went to the Central Bank of the Philippines, wherein we have friends. I went to the hospitals, wherein our friend in the Central Bank has connection. I offered to them the brochure of pillows, complete sets of the bedroom, etc. You know what? Before my parents arrived La Union, I was able to earn more than 10,000 pesos. Because of that direct selling company. And what happened? Of course, did my parents get mad at me? No. Because that 10,000 pesos actually helped us to have our food for the next days. So that's one thing that I would like to share. And if you notice, am I hard-headed that time? My parents told me to wait, but I told to myself, no. I will do this because of what we call persistence. Do you know what is persistence? Actually, it's not just persistence, but it's a decision. I remember I tried to reflect when I was young, because regarding hardships in life, we experience everything. Maybe you will not notice to my body now, but you know, when I was young, we even experience not eating 3 times a day. We even experience that when my father will arrive, because he's driving a jeepney before, that's the only time we can buy a half kilo of rice. I saw my mother went to other friends just to ask for one piece of fish. I saw my mother and father experience those difficulties even when I was young. And I don't know, since the time that I was young, it's like my mind and my heart is already there too to help my family. During December, we are selling firecrackers, and you know what I was doing? They don't know that I am keeping money from the money that we are getting from the sales. Because during that time, they entrust to me the money every night. After the selling time, I go home with that bag full of money. And just now, actually my mother doesn't know about it. I'm revealing to all of you, I'm keeping 10,000, 20,000, or even 30,000 in my cabinet. Why? Because during the time that we don't have money, I'm bringing out those money just to buy food for our family. That's what I was doing. I know it's not right. It's a white lie. It's a white lie. Because they don't know that I'm keeping money. It's like stealing. But to tell you honestly, I use all those money to go back to provide for my family. So that's my story when I was young. And then I graduated high school. I dreamed to be a lawyer. But sad to say, when I graduated high school, my mother experienced a life and death situation. That's the very first time that I saw my mom suffered from that heart problem. The valve of her heart is not functioning well. That's why many times she's experiencing seizure and the tongue is going back. That's why if we cannot manage it, we always bring her to the hospital. And it's very difficult to go to the hospital, am I right? Are you still with me? Okay. Is it difficult to go to the hospital? It's because when you go to the hospital, you know that all your money, especially if you are not rich, all your money will be used just to pay the bills. And then it's like 1 week before the start of the class, I was still not able to go for enrollment. But you know what? The nurse in that ICU taught me a lot of things about nursing interventions. She taught me how to regulate the blood, the fluids. She taught me how to check the temperature. She helped me how to check the blood pressure. And because of that, I was inspired. And I told to myself, okay, I still have my younger brother who need to study. I cannot be selfish. I cannot be selfish to reach my goal to be a lawyer. It's because my parents need to invest 10 years for me to be able to graduate. So I told to myself, okay, I'll study nursing. That's why I became a nurse. It's good that my uncle was also a graduate of that school. They just asked the school to allow me to enroll because the enrollment was already closed. So I graduated nursing, and then after that, I worked abroad. Immediately after passing the board, I worked in the school where I graduated from. I worked there as a clinical instructor. And after that, because the income, the salary that I received that time is not enough for the family, I decided to go to abroad. So it was 2011, April. April 2011, it's April 10, 2011, I went to Saudi Arabia to work as an OFW nurse. What happened? Was I able to provide a better life for my family? Yes. You know what? What is good about our family is that we never dreamed to be rich. We never wanted millions in our bank accounts. What we only want is to have a kitchen full of food, to see our refrigerator full of food, because that's the thing that we were deprived when I was younger. That's why every time I go for a vacation, I make sure that we have a lot of rice, a lot of canned foods, everything. That's already happiness. That's already a feeling of happiness for all of us. It's like my mother, when she saw the kitchen full of food, she will say, oh, it's like we are millionaire. But I think for some of the people here, you will not consider yourself millionaire just to see your kitchen full of food. Am I right? So after that, for a single man, is it already, we call it, at the peak of my career? I'm already 20, I'm just 25, 24 when I went to Saudi Arabia. For 6 years, I worked there as a registered nurse. For 6 years, I was receiving a six-digit salary. Not to brag, but the latest salary that I received that time was 150,000. Because I worked in a government hospital. And is 150,000 enough? Is 150,000 already a blessing? Yes, of course. Because a nurse in the Philippines only receives 7,000 to 20,000 a month. Do you know that? That's why nurses don't stay in the Philippines, they go abroad. Sad to say, nurses who stay in the Philippines, they don't work as a nurse. They go for call center industry. So, it's 6 years. I always go for vacation. I was able to provide a family trip for my family going to Hong Kong. I was able to buy a car for my family, just a surprise. I was able to start a business in front of our house. We have our mini grocery and we have our sari-sari store. I know, mini grocery and water refilling station. Is it already something that we can say the life of my family started to improve? I remember when I was in high school, I told to my mother, I will uplift the life of our family. I will uplift the life of our family. But now, that's my career when I was in Saudi Arabia. So why did I go home? Why did I went back to Philippines? It's because of a tragedy. Do you know what is stroke? Do you know stroke? Do you know how difficult to take good care of a stroke patient? Do you know how difficult to make a stroke patient recover? Of course. One day, during our duty, my close friend from La Union as well, he's also a nurse, he suffered from major stroke in Saudi Arabia. He suffered from major stroke. Sad to say, it's just a mild stroke during the admission in the hospital. But because of wrong action, the patient was not given the emergency medication to manage stroke. His problem was just numbness of the left leg. In the afternoon of the admission, his hand became like this. The following day, his face drooped. And then in the afternoon, he started to have saliva going out. He cannot control his saliva already. And then the following day, our colleagues in Saudi Arabia is already preparing an emergency kit for intubation. All of us there in Saudi Arabia thought that our friend will be giving up his life in Saudi Arabia that time. But our friends told us, if you want this person to survive, better bring him home. So I volunteered to bring him back to the Philippines because we know that in the Philippines, though we don't have those enough advanced equipment, our doctors here in the Philippines are good. Am I right? Yes. So I brought him from airport. His condition was unstable, totally unstable that time. But we showed that he's not that critical. Because if the pilot will see that the person that is about to enter the plane is critical, the pilot has the final say if he will allow that person to ride the plane or not. So what I did, because he cannot already balance his own body, I just hold his clothes and tie it in my hands while holding the wheelchair, just to show that he's okay. But during that time, he's already on catheter. He cannot control his urination. And from airport, my parents saw how pale my friend was when we arrived na Iya. And from that airport, ambulance conduction, we went to La Union. in a hospital in La Union. Sad to say, is it okay if the doctor will prescribe to you an expensive medication, but it will really help you? Of course. But you know what? Sad to say, that doctor gave my friend a 5 days injection, which we call immunoglobulin, which cost my friend 550,000. 550,000 injection that is not needed for his case. We actually wanted to sue that doctor. But why we did not do that? There's this one woman who showed a good deed, an act of good deed. She actually sent a bottle of pure tear. She sent a bottle of pure tear containing 10 capsules. Every time I share, I always remember that 10 capsule. You know that 10 capsule? What I felt, what was my reaction when I received that bottle? I told to myself, she is so crazy. Why? She went to the terminal just to send a bottle that is not full. You know, it's very difficult, especially here in Manila. You go to the station, what's this? Wasting your time just to send a bottle that is not full, which contains only 10 capsules. I actually laughed that time. And she told me, just let him take one capsule a day just to try. And you know what? It reached 5 days, 7 days. I saw my friend who is pale started to have color again. It's like a plant that is about to dry, that when you water it, it starts to live again. Before the 10 days, I told this woman, ma'am, what is that medication that you sent us? King, I gave you brochure. I gave you the reading materials. Kindly read it. And I told her, okay, I will read it. But she didn't know that time I never read those articles or those papers that she sent us. That's why I accumulate those things in our house. So she sent a bottle of pure tear. She said, okay, you let Jeff take 2 capsules in the morning, 2 capsules in the evening. So what happened? Without a joke, after 3 weeks of taking of that 2 capsules, of that maroon capsule in the morning and in the evening, 3 weeks, that major stroke that is bedridden was able to stand. That stroke patient was able to walk, to talk, and he started to remember everything. Is it amazing? Yes. As a nurse, I told to myself, what is this capsule? Why? Because I know in the hospital, a stroke patient, especially a major stroke patient, even with a regular physiotherapy, you need a year or two before you can make that person stand. Do you agree? But that maroon capsule, in 3 weeks' time, that pure tear placenta, that very crazy capsule that helped a lot of patients, was able to help my friend. So what happened? Did I believe pure tear that time? No. Still no. Why? Oh, maybe it's just, it's just a chance. It's like a coincidence. Maybe it's just coincidence. So that lady went to La Union. She traveled 7 hours to visit us. She treated us in a restaurant. And you know what? She gave me 1 capsule. She gave my mother 1 capsule to take. What happened? During the night, that's the best night I had after that very stressful months of taking good care of a patient who suffered from stroke. That very first night, I was able to sleep, a very good sleep. And I thank pure tear because of that. And you know what? Let's go back to that date, to that snack time with this lady. You know what she said? She presented to us pure tear like how it is being presented to all of you. And you know what she told me? King, you check this one. This is stem cell. And you know, me and my mother, we are actually doing like this behind the table. Because why? She gave pure tear for free. She gave pure tear for free, and now she's selling pure tear to us. OMG. Oh my gosh. If you are the beneficiary of a free capsule and you saw that the patient improved, if I will sell to you that product, will you buy? Because you will be ashamed not to buy. you will be ashamed not to buy from me. Am I right? And she told me, King, don't be fool, don't be crazy. I'm not selling pure tear. Just make sure that Jeff is taking that pure tear capsule religiously. And you know what? I still remember, she held my hand and she said, everything that was lost in Saudi Arabia, I will help you. I will help you regain it even hundredfolds. And you know who that lady is? Do you want to know who she is? Do you want to know who she is? Okay. After I call her name, can you please give her a warm round of applause? That lady is actually the Reway Philippines newest Team Elite Pegasus, Miss Jedda Monte. And every time I share, I never forget to say thank you. Ma'am, in front of all the people of the Reway Philippines, walang hanggang pasasalamat po. Forever, I, my family, and my team will always be grateful that you brought us to this platform. So now, she told us, King, maybe you can go to Manila because my boss, I want my boss to meet Jeff. And we actually had that, we think, maybe it's not possible, but you know what, she left La Union. And the following day, she called me, King, you must come. And I don't know, but I felt something. All my hair stood up, and I said, okay, ma'am, we will go. And you know what happened? She even paid for our coat. Me and my friend, who's doing like this that time, from being bedridden, he's doing like this. She paid for our coat. She even rented a condominium for us. She facilitated our transportation just to go to the office, just to go to Marriott Hotel to attend the same seminar that you are all attending now. And you know what I felt that time? I felt so out of place because I saw a lot of people wearing like this. They're all beautiful. They're all handsome. Am I right? Give them a round of applause. And during that time, I was so haggard. And my friend is stroke patient. And then, you know what? We are actually sitting at the same chair that you are all now. So for all the first-timers, you know, I was once in your chair. That was more than a year ago. I was once in your chair. I was once a listener who listened to a lot of Pegasus who talk about leadership seminar. And one of the speakers was our Team Elite, Ma'am Sansan, and of course, her husband, Sir William, and Adrian Ong, and others. And you know what? I don't know anything what's really going on in that seminar. But what happened, why I'm already part of Freeway? Like all the speakers, like all of the people here are telling, you must choose to be hit. So now, I would like to ask all of you, do you choose to be hit? In Tagalog, tanggapin mong mabaril kayo ng lahat ng sinasabi ko. Okay po ba yon? You choose to be hit because if more than a year ago, I was sitting there and I dreamed to be one of the speaker here, I am so amazed that I'm already sitting near Ma'am Sansan. Everything is possible. So after that, we went to the Reway office. And here comes the Malaysian, Mr. Raymond Tong. Let's give him a warm of applause. You know what happened that time? He asked all of us to go out the room. And he said, all the distributors without stars go out. And then I asked Dr. Yap, Doc, what is that star all about? No, it's just a rank of the company. Okay. So why he let us go? He want us to go out. Because he's actually fixing the chair from the Team Elite going to the 3-star, 2-star, and 1-star. And during that time, I don't know what is the star all about. But you know what I told to Dr. Rayab? Doc, what is the minimum rank here in Reway? It's 1-star, she told me. I will never go back to this office without being 1-star. I told her. So confident. So confident, right? It sounds boastful. But you know, I asked her, what is one star? You must be able to close 8 sets. What 8 sets? 1 set during the time was 125,000. OMG, it's 1 million. So I told to Dr. Rayap, maybe you will never see me in this office again. That's actually what I told to Dr. Rayap. And you know what? I saw how they presented the product, and I told to Ma'am Jeddah, just to think, I never had even a single person of intention to be a distributor of this company. All I know that time is, I would like to offer my service because that's the only thing I can offer that time because I don't have money anymore. I told her, Ma'am, okay, I know how you're presenting the product, so you can present in La Union. I will facilitate, I will reserve the restaurant, I will call all my friends, my teachers, everybody that I know, I will call them, just pay the restaurant. And whatever sales, at least, I was able to give back a bit of what she did to us. Am I right? And I was so shocked, and I was so thankful that for the very first time, the husband and wife, Dr. Yap, was the one, together with their niece, Mr. Nick, presented in La Union for the first time. Let's give them a warm round of applause. And you know what happened? After that presentation, 8 people trusted PureTear. Yes. So what do you mean by that? I went back to the office, Diamond 1 star. But did I know that? No. Here comes Sir Wally. He showed me the account. It says there, welcome King Bernardi. Why my name is there? Because you are already a distributor of Freeway. Really? And he showed me the wallet and he said, you convert this one. What is that 153,000? I know, 146,000. That's your income. What? I told him, I came here in Manila just to give you the money and to get stuck, and I just asked Ma'am Jeddah to give me a reimbursement of the fare and a little budget for food. I was so shocked that they gave me that opportunity to be a distributor of this company. And I thank them for that. And you know, for more than 10 months, running to 11 months after I left Saudi Arabia, did I feel depressed? Yes, because you know why I felt depressed that time? Because I saw my mother and father start to suffer again. It came to a point that I only budget 3,000 pesos for the 1 week food for our family, because the income of our business is not enough to provide a good dinner, a good meal for my family again. So I was so shocked. On my 11th, I was actually, before Riway came, I was selling sweets, spreads like peanut butter. I'm riding a motorcycle, selling in the school. I go for meet up at the mall. You know, I felt very small that time. Why? I was a nurse. I'm a nurse. I have license. I was an ex-OFW who's earning more than 100,000 a month. Then suddenly, everything was gone. Everything was gone. And I'm only holding how many peso? 100 peso for one chicharon. 200 peso for a peanut butter. And my profit is only 50 pesos, 20 pesos. Will that be enough? No. But after that, Riway came. Because of that simple sacrifice that Ma'am Jeddah was able to do for our friend. And that's the start. After that first month in Riway, the second month, you know, I was able to close 50 sets. On my second month, I was able to close 50 sets without downlines. Because I don't know that it's a networking company. On my third month, I was able to close again another 48 sets without product. During that time, there is an issue with the product availability. But you know what? little did I know that I'm already running for Team Elit Pavo that time. But I was just shocked that Coach Raymond was always saying, "This man from La Union." It's like, oh, I'm a celebrity already. But I didn't know what is the rank before. And then, you know what? Those rank was able to give me 7-digit income. 7-digit. And you know what? I prayed to our Almighty before. I said, why my life is going back again to that very difficult day like what I experienced when I was young. But you know what? I saw that 10 months of hardship, He just prepared me for something big. Yes. He prepared me for something big that I never imagined, that I never expected to happen. Like, just to recap, 11th month in the Philippines, I earned 1 month of my salary in Saudi Arabia. On my anniversary in the Philippines as a jobless nurse, I was able to earn more than 1 year of my salary in Saudi Arabia. And I think Reway, the Reway platform, is providing that to anybody. And you know, maybe you're wondering, he's a nurse, right? I'm a nurse. I am a nurse. I should be wearing white uniform. I should be wearing my scrub suits. I should be handling patients, suctioning their secretion, checking their temperature. I should be inside the hospital now. But why I am here? Why am I here? It's because this company is very different. This company, like what everybody is saying, this is a life-changing experience. So let's give Reway a round of applause. So maybe you're thinking, what is the essence of emptying your cup? Is it difficult to empty your cup? For all of you, like what I said earlier, either what profession or vocation that you have, I know it's very difficult to empty your cup, especially if you're a doctor, if you're a lawyer, you studied, you invested more than 10 years of your time just to learn, just to get your license. Like for me, I studied 4 years college to get that nursing degree. But aside from that 4 years, you go for your elementary, you go to your secondary. So you actually invested more than 10 years just to learn, just to get that license. I remember when I was a nurse, if somebody will ask me, oh, my son is having fever, what should I do? Give paracetamol. Oh, my aunt is suffering from pain. Give pain reliever. Oh, my aunt is suffering from cancer. I know the doctor will give chemotherapy. Am I right? But, you know, the day that our general manager gave me this topic, that's the only time I realized I was able to empty my cup. Without knowing. Unconsciously, I empty my cup. Why? Now, after I start doing Reway, I told, if somebody was asking, oh, there's fever, there's low hemoglobin, low sugar, high sugar, Parkinson's, cancer. My aunt is not able to walk because of arthritis. You know the only answer that I tell them? Take your tear. Take your tear. But did I study about your tear before? No. Did I study about stem cell before? No. Because when you go back to your book, your book will answer what is the medication for those illnesses. Am I right? So it's very difficult to empty your cup. But can you do it?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. But during that time that we will have to do it, I doubt that all of you can do it. Why? If you invested more than 10 years just to study nurse, doctor, or medicine, or nursing, or lawyer, it's very difficult to set aside what you learned just to listen to a younger man, to a younger woman, to tell you this can cure, not that one. Am I right? But you know, I actually asked my mentor, Ma'am, this is the topic given to me, emptying your cup. And you know what she told me? You are the epitome of emptying your cup. Why? I didn't know anything about the business. All I know that time, PureTear is effective. PureTear can help regain health. That's all I know, because I hate networking. So that's the start of my journey in Reway. So if you are able to empty your cup, but you know what? A lot of people doesn't want to empty their cup because of pride. Because of pride. Oh, I'm a medical doctor. I'm a consultant. I'm a lawyer. Why should I listen to you? Because a lot of distributors like me, we are not all in the medical field. We have a millionaire here, a taxi driver, the very first in the Philippines, Mr. Rex Bugcalaw. If you're a doctor, will you listen to a taxi driver saying the cancer can be helped with PureTear? Will you listen to a tricycle driver saying, oh, PureTear is the answer for that arthritis? I doubt, because of pride. Another, arrogance and ignorance. Arrogance and ignorance. Some people will say, oh, I'm not on networking. I don't want to learn that. Arrogance, some people will say, because of their social status in life, I'm rich. I don't want alternative medicine. I can pay the most expensive hospital, even outside the Philippines, just for a cure. Is it correct? A lot of rich people who are suffering from illness, you're giving them the answer to their illness, they will say, I'd rather go for chemotherapy. I can pay even the most expensive brand. I can even pay the most expensive doctor. I can even go outside the country just for treatment. But sad to say, are they cured? You have hypertension, 10 years you're taking maintenance, are you cured? No. That's the wonder of PureTear. Because PureTear can regain your health. Am I right? Okay. So that's emptying your cup. So if you're able to empty your cup, is that enough for you to be successful? No. Because if you're an empty cup, that's the most dangerous. That's the most dangerous state of mind that you have. Why? Because anything can enter your system. Am I right? Anything can enter your system. So you have to be careful to fill up your cup with what is right. So what is right? You have to listen to people who reach success. You have to duplicate the people who already reach success. Why? Those people who reach success once a failure. Was once a failure. Did you hear a success story telling, it is my first try and I reached the finish line successfully? No. That's why you know in this industry, we have upline and downline that I started to learn already. This is my first time. You know what? Uplines will never bring you to a situation that will put you harm. Okay. Uplines will never put you in a very negative or very crucial situation. Why? Uplines will benefit from you. Do you know that? If your upline will teach you right, what will happen to them? They will earn. So do you think uplines will allow you to fail? No, never. Am I right? That's why if your upline will tell you, King, stay in La Union. What should you do? Stay in La Union. If your upline will tell, do weekly OPP. No, I will just do once a month. You know what? Just listen. Sometimes people are already focusing on books. Do you know that? People loves to read books. Am I right? And a lot of people, they already set their minds that the book can make them rich. I don't condemn education. Education is something important as well because it's the only legacy that our parents can give us that can never be stealed. Am I right? But you know what? There's just one thing that I would like to share to all of you. I was a nurse. I bought a lot of thick books, but it didn't make me rich. Medical surgical book, we have volume 1 and volume 2. Pharmacology book, more than 300, 500 pages, 1,000 pages. Every aspect of our course, we have a lot of book. Am I right? You know what? if books can make people rich, to tell you, more than 90% of the world population are already rich now. But did it happen? No. That's why, after you empty your cup, you have to prepare yourself to be armored with new things. You have to prepare yourself to listen. That's what we have in Reway. We are following the experience of the leaders that already failed at once and reached success. Why your upline is already in front? It's simply because they failed twice, but they stood up thrice. Do you know that?
Yes.
And there's another learning. Do you know the word learning? Okay. Forget about the book. This is what one thing I would like to share to all of you. All of us, we experience studying. We experience to go to school. Either you finish or not, you paid tuition fee before, correct? If the school is prestigious, you have to pay thousands, hundred thousands. I wonder, because in this industry that we have, Reway is actually giving us free education. Free, can you repeat? Free education. If at school you have to pay tuition fee, miscellaneous, you have to buy books, you have to wear uniforms, in Reway, you just go to the office, the company will even give you free dinner. Am I right? And if you stay there a whole day, your uplines will give you free lunch. Free snack. Am I right? You know what? As uplines, the only thing that we want to see to all our downlines is to see commitment. It's very difficult to go to school. Am I right? When we were younger, Monday to Friday, we go to school. When we reach college, we even go to school 6 or 7 days a week. But in Reway, you just have to go to the office once to twice a week just to learn for free. That's why I really wonder. When I was given this topic, I really reflected a lot. I really wonder why a lot of people are already given this opportunity, but only few are going to the office to learn for free. Why? Maybe it's because they are still comfortable with their life. Maybe because, we know everything already. Because people who don't go for training, people who don't go for education, there's one keyword that I will tell you. They are not able to empty their cup. They don't want to learn because they know that they are better than what Reway will teach them. But for those people who go for continuous training, you're already a blessing. Why? It's because once you equip yourself with that armor in you, after emptying your cup, you equip yourself with that training that Reway is giving to all of you. You are not just changing your life. You are actually changing the life of all the people surrounding you. Let's give Reway a round of applause. Okay. So now let's talk about armoring yourself. I'll just show you something. Is Reway difficult to do? Is Reway difficult to do? I talk about books. Whatever your course was, you were able to read 100 pages or 1,000 pages of books before. Am I right? But you know what, Reway? Reway is just simple. It's actually providing you 13 pages of booklet. This booklet, you know what? Do you know this? This is an OPP booklet. These 13 pages that even if you are not a graduate, even you're an elementary graduate, you can learn how to use this booklet. Am I right? This 40 pesos booklet will actually bring you millions in your bank accounts. So this very simple armor that we have, this is something that a lot of leaders don't appreciate. We always look for OPP booklet. Why? You don't need to bring laptop every day. When you're riding a Grab, talk to the Grab driver. Sir, are you familiar with the death sentence without committing any crime? Do you know what is the reason why Chocolate died? It's because of heart disease. Do you have a mother who suffered from stroke? Do you know what is diabetes? Everything is here. And this is a fact telling that these diseases kills more than 50% of the world population each day. So this thing will only, actually, if you will focus on this, you can learn this one in less than an hour. Is it difficult to learn the 13 pages? No. But why a lot of distributors doesn't know to present up to now? Because you don't want to be a millionaire? Or you are still comfortable with your life? So aside from this, in doing this industry, you are actually, let's be honest. Money is part, am I right? Money is part of the motivation of every individual, because without money, you cannot buy your food. Without money, you can't buy your house. Am I right? Though our company is product-oriented company, it's also a must for you to learn how is it really to earn in Reway. So aside from that product presentation, you must equip yourself to know how it is to learn, because if there are people under you who took peer-to-peer and started to improve, for sure they will be interested to become a distributor. Not to earn, but because they wanted to let their family member take peer-to-peer for free. Am I right? Yes. You know what? Some distributors, our mistake is, if there are 7 family members who are sick, okay, ma'am, you buy 7 sets. You have to give me 945,000. No. You have to let them try. You know that 7 sets that you're aiming, after they try that 1 set, it will bring you more than 50 sets. Because the product is effective. So you have to armor yourself. But, again, it's a decision. You know what? Either you are a Team Elite Pegasus, a Pavo, a Phoenix, a 1-star, a 3-star, or a new distributor, or just an invite who doesn't know why you are here, you know what I would like to tell to all of you? Don't be a butterfly. Do you know what is a butterfly? Are you familiar with a butterfly? Do not live like a butterfly. Why? Is butterfly beautiful? You know what? After being a caterpillar, once the butterfly spread its wings, once the butterfly spread its wings, you have to count 5 to 7 days, the butterfly will die. In this industry that we are into, your shine, your fame, or your rank should not just be for 5 to 7 days. Your rank should not be for 5 to 7 days only. It's like today, oh, you're very beautiful, but after 5 days, you're down. You have to act like a human. Because we are created humans, we are the highest form of? What? We are the highest form, that's all. And our Almighty gave us the opportunity to change other people's lives. So today, before I have to finish my talk, I would like to tell to all of you everything that you listen, everything, every word that came out from our mouths, from the morning talk up to now, up to the next speakers, these are all truth. Before, I always remember, Reway will change your life. Woo! Reway is a life-changing experience. Woo! What are they talking about? But you know what? Reway has brought breakthrough to me, to my family, and to all the people that trusted me. So I would like to ask all of you, is it easy to empty your cup? Is it easy to empty your cup? Yes. If emptying your cup will make you millionaire, will you do it?
Yes.
Will you do it?
Yes.
For those who say no, it's up to you. Okay. So before we end, can I request all of you to bring out your phones? But before that, I would like to tell you one word, one quotation. I would like to share to all of you. Today's sunrise does not define itself by yesterday's sunset. I repeat, today's sunrise does not define itself by yesterday's sunset. Do you agree? Before I end, I would like to tell you, all of us committed mistakes. Am I right?
Yes.
All of us, we have our own story of being broken. If you will imprison yourself to that mistake, will you reach success? Will you reach success? No. So your mistake yesterday, don't base everything on your mistake. Because each day that we are given, each sunrise that we are experiencing is a new day, is a new chance that given to us to be a better person. And you know, everything that matters in life requires risk. Can you repeat with me? Everything that matters in life requires risk. So I would like to ask you, will you risk something just to get what matters in you? Because you know what? Like all the speakers are saying, if you want to succeed, you have to risk. If you want to fail, don't risk? No. Actually, if you risk, you can be a success, you can be a failure. But if you don't risk, neither you're successful nor failure. Because living is different from existing. Do you know that?
Yes.
Because if you don't want to risk anything, it's simply living like breathing with no mission, with no purpose. So don't tell that if you don't want to risk, you are a failure. No, you're a stagnant water. Hopeless. Hopeless, purposeless. It's simply better to die. So do you want to die? You want to live. If you want to live, you are meant to reach success. So now, I would like to end my talk by asking all of you to open your phones and put it in selfie mode. Can you do that for me? Okay. You open your phone, put it in selfie mode. You know, the world has full of problems. Do you agree with me? The world has full of problems. Each day, each second of our life, we are facing trials, we are facing problems. But Reway platform is providing something that will change the world, not for worst, but for a better. It starts with the changing of life of every individual, every family, every society. Now, look at your camera phones, and now look at this slide. Because you are the solution to today's problems. Just one decision. You decide to do Reway, you decide to be a better person, you decide to change the life of your family for a better, and you will have tomorrow that's something you never imagined. Good afternoon. Once again, I'm King Bernardi. This is the end of my talk.
Let's give King another round of applause. I don't know whether you learned something through his sharing just now. Did you?
Yes.
Because I did. I did. I learned so much. And it's such a reminder. Because every time we come to a point in life, we are not ready to reset ourselves, to start again, to learn again. It's actually a very, very good reminder. Resetting, emptying our cup. And if we are able to do it every day, wow. After 365 days, we would have learned as much as 365 full cups of water. And that is a very big growth. We might see one day is one cup, but 1 year, we got to look long term. We have to look long term. So really, the thing is, the problem, the trouble with people today, men or women, the first problem is not to learn, but to unlearn. You get what I mean? The problem is not to learn. Learning is easy. The difficult thing is unlearning it. To start again. And I really need to give King another round of applause, really, for such a good reminder to always reset and relearn.